Hello and welcome to the Grand Line Review, your source for everything One Piece. Today we are going to be looking into a fairly crazy cool yet very spooky devil fruit for the encyclopedia, known as the Horohoro no Mi. The Horohoro no Mi is a paramecia type fruit that allows its user to generate ghosts, as well as bestow the user with some sort of control of their own spirit. It was consumed in the series by profound symbol of gothic Lolita fashion, Perona, and first put on display during the Thriller Bark arc. This fruit, rather interestingly, takes its name from the English word holo, which would be pronounced as horo in Japanese, which is quite intriguing, because holos as monsters in the Western world generally assume a corporeal existence, whereas this fruit's focus is more on the spiritual, more akin to the idea as a holo as presented in, say, Bleach, for example. In any case, it becomes a somewhat clear reference to the ghostly nature of this devil fruit, as the creatures it produces are referred to as holos themselves, and as such both Viz and Funimation elected to translate it as the holo fruit. So, ghosts. What can we do with them? Well, apparently quite a devastating amount actually. However, first of all, it should be noted that any holos produced with the Horohoro no Mi are entirely immune to any sort of physical attacks, which actually very potentially includes haki-coated attacks as well, making them extraordinarily difficult, if not impossible to stop, should you be targeted by one of them. And these unstoppable ghosts come in a fair few different varieties, the most common of which displayed in the series are the negative holos. Now, should an individual have a negative holo pass through them, or the other way around, they will immediately be struck with severe depression, becoming supremely negative and often even contemplating suicide, which sounds incredibly dark, and in reality, yeah, it would be, but it's often used for very comic effect in the series. These negative holos are also effective against those of particularly strong wills, as they have been shown to instantly throw traditionally strong-minded characters, such as Luffy and Zoro, into an instant depression. As a result, I don't think it's out of the realm of possibility whatsoever to suggest that a similar effect could be experienced by even the most legendary figures in the world, like Warlords of the Sea, Admirals, or possibly even the Four Emperors. However, with that said, the effects of the negative holos are quite temporary, meaning that they would generally be best used to secure a momentary advantage against a particular opponent, or by having them continuously pass through someone to initiate some sort of chain depression effect. Although, quite notably, these holos are actually completely ineffective against those who already carry a pessimistic attitude. And not only that, should the holos pass through such a being, it can actually cause the holos themselves to collapse in depression instead. Luckily, there are other options though, as the user of the Horohoro no Mi can conjure mini holos, which, despite still being immune to any sort of physical damage, can be triggered by the user to cause a relatively powerful explosion. And this can be taken a step further with the Toku Holo, which essentially acts in the same way, except it is a much more bigger bomb, causing significantly more devastating damage. Furthermore, the user of this fruit has one particularly outstanding feature in regards to these holos, as they are actually able to link their consciousness to the ghosts, meaning that they become exceptionally useful for scouting purposes, given that there is no way of damaging them and no obstacle that they cannot pass, except probably sea stone. But you'd need like an entire room made out of sea stone for them to not be able to infiltrate. In addition to all of this spiritual mayhem, the user is also granted abilities in regards to control of their own spirit via a technique known as Yutai Ridatsu, which is essentially astral projection. Now, interestingly enough, this is not like the astral projection effect we explored previously with the Yomi Yomi no Mi, whereby the user can remove their soul from their body and float around the world that way, appearing to be a colored cloud sort of thingy. But this is not the case with the Horohoro no Mi, as the spirit of the Horohoro user appears to be a perfect replica of them, but in ghostly form. Now, I should also note that the Viz manga translation refers to this ability as the removal of the soul from the body, while the anime translation chooses to phrase it as an out-of-body experience, which is why I'm being very careful to say spirit rather than soul in this case, because there is a striking difference in the phenomena caused by these fruits. So I suppose you could think of it as the user of the Yomi Yomi no Mi releases their life essence, while the user of the Horohoro no Mi engages in more of a projection of consciousness. However, both fruits do share a similar weakness, in that in order to engage in these abilities, their bodies are left entirely defenseless. However, in regards to the user of the Horohoro no Mi, they also seem to be entirely capable of manipulating their spirit as well, changing its size and so on and so forth. And the true potential of this manipulation is unknown, and incredibly bizarre options may be available to particularly creative users. And speaking of, that sounds like a good cue to start discussing Perona's use of the fruit, and I'd have to say that she is pretty fantastic. She's demonstrated a great amount of versatility by engaging in all of the aforementioned techniques, but I'd like to draw particular attention to a system developed known as the Ghost Network. Essentially, Perona crafts a vast amount of holos and spreads them throughout an entire island, linking her consciousness to all of them and becoming a very effective surveillance machine. But I do have to say, aside from this brilliantly designed system, Perona's use of the fruit in this series is mainly for comical effect, and I don't think it quite lives up to its overwhelming potential. And as for just what potential it could hold in the area of an awakening, it is fairly maddening to think about. Just as I speculated with the Yomi Yomi no Mi, the user of the Horohoro no Mi may very potentially gain access to the manipulation of other people's spirits rather than simply their own. And what I'm thinking of is a sort of Doctor Strange effect of being able to forcibly submit them to astral projection, thus leaving their body open to any form of attack, and not only that, but also potentially being able to manipulate their spirit form as well. Some other miscellaneous things to consider when becoming a spirit human. I said earlier that the hollows created by the user of this fruit may be impossible to harm even through Haki-coated attacks. However, I suppose I should also note that it may be possible to prevent the hollows from making contact with you if you are able to coat your entire body in armament Haki. And apparently, it's also possible to use the Horohoro Numi not only to make your astral projection float, but also your own physical body, making this one of those wonderfully rare devil fruits that offer its user the potential of flight. Look, this fruit is pretty damn amazing. With a proficient user, you would more or less become a completely untouchable entity. For example, if anybody threatens you physically, all you need to do is have a negative holo move through them to incapacitate them, and should they be at a critical level of pessimism, then you can also bombard them with explosions with the mini and toku holos. The astral projection aspect is also incredibly amazing, and the fruit itself is just so useful to those who are generally curious about the world, because with the Horohoro Numi, there is not going to be anything capable of hiding anyone's secrets from your prying eyes and ears. And then there are the odd little things such as the potential to fly, and you know what? You have yourself a done deal for me. This fruit has such an incredible amount of life-changing potential that I would certainly call it one of the most versatile Paramecia fruits in the entire series. So you know what? Sign me up. And with that, we are going to commit the Horohoro Numi to the Devil Fruit Encyclopedia. Next week, we will be continuing to pursue the dark and creepy corner of the Devil Fruit world by looking into the shadow manipulation abilities of the Kagekage no Mi. If you enjoyed this video and the content this channel produces in general, then please do consider donating to the Grandline Review Patreon, because the support of all of you amazing people is what continues to make this channel possible. And if you'd like to see more videos like this but apply to other anime and manga series, then please do check out my second channel, New World Review, for all of your wider needs. And if you'd like to join the fun at any time, then please do head over to my Discord server, where a wide array of shenaniganry takes place on a daily basis. And finally, please do comment with your thoughts on the Horohoro no Mi. This has been the Grandline Review, and I'll see you next time. Blah, blip, blah, blip, 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 blah, 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 blah.